Hello viewers, you are watching Mojo for Industry, India's first mobile journalism platform for industry. The Automotive Component Manufacturer Association of India, that is ACMA, is the apex body representing the interests of the Indian auto component industry. Its membership of over 800 manufacturers contributes more than 85% of the auto component industry's turnover in the organized sector. Today we have Mr. Vinnie Mehta, Director General of ACMA, with us to share more details about the performance of the industry. Thank you so much, Mr. Mehta, for accepting our invitation and being here in the show. Could you give us a brief overview of the performance of auto component industry in India?
The entire automotive industry is a very key contributor to India's economy and the GDP. The overall auto industry contributes about 7% to India's GDP, whereas the auto component industry alone contributes around 2.5%. And we're also a very sizable employment generator. Our estimate is that we create about 5 million or 50 lakh jobs directly across the sector. And that apart, we have a cumulative gross block, which is the investments, including the historical investments that we have made, is to the tune of about 12 to 13 odd billion US dollars. So in that sense, and the auto component industry is a very sizable contributor to economy, job creation. And I think we all know that the industry is going through a very tough phase. Every industry, in fact, at this juncture is going through a tough phase, to be very honest. So when the year ended for March 2020, the turnover of the auto component industry stood at 50 billion US dollar. Okay, and almost more than 6 months have gone by. The first 3 months of the quarter, because of the pandemic, if I may say, were complete washout, because in the month of April, almost till mid-May, and there were no vehicle sales, and as a result of which there was literally no production of components because of the pandemic situation. And then as the sector started opening up with in tandem with the economy, opening up, we've seen month-on-month increase in vehicle sales and back-to-back increase in production in the component sector. And I would like to be given to understand that October, November, the turnover of the component industry probably, or the production of the component industry, has reached the pre-COVID levels, largely led by very significant production and growth of passenger vehicles, the two-wheeler industry, and of course the tractor industry. We're also very happy to sort of note at this juncture that there is uptick in the commercial vehicle industry. So those component suppliers who have been associated with the commercial vehicle industry is also seeing increased in production, but the commercial vehicle production is much too lower than what was in the pre-COVID level. Many reasons to it, one of them being that vehicle industry was increased by 25% in 2018-19, and that in some sense sucked away the demand, and then there was a pandemic. All in all, I would like to say that at this juncture, the turnaround in the industry is very, very satisfactory. We keep our fingers closed. Hopefully, the festive season was very bountiful for the automotive industry and the auto component industry. We hope that the good tidings will prevail, and that we will be able to sustain demand, and that things will improve month on month, keeping fingers crossed. But also, it's very important to note that the year, and the next fiscal year, is being projected as the year of recovery or the year of rebound.
Right, so as you said, that next year can be a year of recovery. So by when we can expect the green shoot for the automotive component industry, when the pre-COVID level of?
When I talk about vehicle sales, say the sales of commercial, the sales of passenger vehicles, the sales of two-wheelers have already reached the pre-COVID levels. Okay, the tractor sales, in fact, when they were impacted because of the COVID and the related lockdowns, because the tractor industry or the farm equipment industry was allowed to function without any challenges or without any embargo in that sense in the COVID period. And that was one industry that functioned and didn't suffer lockdown. And very interestingly, because of a very bountiful monsoon and agricultural growth, the tractor industry performance has been more than 100%. So those sectors in the component industry who were supplying to these three industries are now sort of in that sense recovered or have reached pre-COVID levels. As I said, the commercial vehicle industry seems to be recovering, and I just hope that sooner or later they will reach their pre-COVID levels. Probably it will take them a year to do so. And so things are improving, and that's very, very reassuring. The challenge is that how to keep the demand sustained, which would in turn mean that, you know, the growth story continues. Yeah.
Right. So apart from this COVID-19, which was quite uncertain, you know, BS6 implementation was a kind of a challenge for the industry, especially the automotive industry and the allied industries. So how do you see its impact on the component sector?
So in that sense, it's very good to you know, follow global standards, and it sets you to, you know, push yourself to be globally competitive, making products that can be consumed in other markets. You know, the challenge is that when regulations come in too soon, or they are ad hocish, you know, that creates a little problem, as we saw in the case of a migration from BS4 to BS6, wherein, you know, India migrated in just 3 years, from 2017 till 2020, and we are very proud of the fact that we could do that, whereas Europe took something like 12 years to do so. Now, so our request to the government is that, look, we're absolutely happy to walk the talk in that sense, the roadmap that is set. But, you know, the moot point is that there should be a roadmap, a very, very well-defined roadmap on technology, on policy. It should be a long-term, stable roadmap, and we should avoid any knee-jerkish, you know, implementation or announcements. And the industry should be taken completely on board, because what happens is the challenge that we witnessed in case of BS6 implementation is that since it came too soon, it did not allow time for localization, and therefore you continue to import a lot of the BS6 related components. So the plea is that, look, you know, have the industry on boarded so that we can localize, and localization is in the interest of everybody. It would be a very price sensitive market. We can really, really offer very price competitive products if technological items are also made in India. We are a very competitive industry in that sense. So I think the industry is maturing today. We have all the capability to be globally competitive.
So when you say that we are becoming globally competitive as well as attaining international standard, where do India's homegrown automotive components brand stand in the global market?
We are a very export competitive industry. We export sort of 25% of our production. So for year ending March 2020, when our turnover stood at $50 billion, we exported around $14.5 billion. Okay, that's more than 25%. And our largest exports market are the EU, or more than 30% goes to EU, and followed by North America, which is again around 28%. And we export to global OEMs and to tier ones. Okay, so we are a you know, so that speaks volumes of our competitiveness, of our competence, of our, you know, the quality of the product that we supply. Okay, I would say that we are one industry that can really scale up very, very fast. But yes, it's not so easy either to break into global supply chains. But I do hope that the PLI scheme the government has announced for the automotive sector will enable us to do so.
Though you said that we have a very, you know, high volume of export, but the share of domestic auto parts industry in global automotive trade is still a minuscule of 1.3%. Yes. So what are you doing to increase the market share as an association? How are you going to project a brand India?
Yeah. You know, we're working very closely with the government on the PLI, and you know, the very fact that the government sort of made the maximum allocation in the PLI to the auto component of the overall, if I recall, 1.45 lakh crore that is allocated, more than 40% is for auto component or the automotive industry. So that's again speaks volumes of the confidence of the government in our sector, and it'll be our endeavor to make sure that we do not let the government down.
You spoke about the PLI scheme. Could you let us know more exactly that how it's going to make an impact on the automotive company industry?
We are looking at the PLI scheme is that how it could help us. You know, the challenges in India are, say, known to everybody. It's land, labor, energy cost, you know, cost of capital, so logistics. Say in logistics, you know, we can be challenged sort of by 10 to 15%, we become non-competitive, okay? Now, if all the factors of production are made available to us at international pricing, okay, we can absolutely beat anybody and everybody. And then I hope the PLI will help us, you know, in some sense, tide over the challenges of cost of doing business in India. And, you know, we will be able to offer globally priced competitive products.
So the past year was very challenging almost for every industry. And now the next is the financial or union budget, which is expected in the next 3 months or so, next quarter. So what are your expectations from the forthcoming union budget from the ACMA's point of view?
Well, we do not have too many asks in the budget. You know, maybe one odd thing that the government can look at is to sort of ensure that there's a uniform GST rate on all the auto component. We suffer two GST rates, one at 18% and another at 28%. Almost 60% of our items are at 18%, while the rest is at 28%. So if the government can make it a uniform rate, and that will be very, very great, because, you know, we have an aftermarket where, you know, suffers from gray market, and that's because of the high rate of taxation. So we're only looking for if the rate of uniform GST would be very conducive to the industry. And that apart, there are certain procedural issues, you know, which are very mundane in that sense. Nothing very a big ask, but just that if the GST rate could be made uniform also in the budget, if there could be now incentives for say growth or let's say we believe that the government has done very well when it comes to addressing supply side challenges, but if there could be incentives for creating demand in the automotive sector, that could be really very, very helpful.
Will you be presenting anything in regards to that incentive what you were asking?
Not have a direct ask per se, it's more of an ask of the vehicle industry, you know, and that is essentially again, you know, if the GST rate on the vehicles could be lowered to 18% from the existing 28%. And secondly, most importantly, if the scrappage policy could be announced, you know, that's has been long awaited, a scrappage policy that could take off from off the road very, very old vehicles that are polluting, and thus could create replacement demand, especially the commercial vehicle industry, which I mentioned is suffering, a demand creation there would be a shot in the arm for the whole value chain in that sense. Yeah, but on the GST front, I do understand the challenges that the government has in terms of the revenue shortfall that they have.
So just to conclude, sir, we are almost at the end of 2020, so no looking back. So what's your roadmap for ACMA in 2021?
And more than anything else, when I look at 2020, I look at it with a lot of pride, because the way the industry has fought for itself, the way we have stood by each other, the way we have in some sense, jointly climbed a mountain of pandemic, okay, and come out as a very, very resilient industry, okay. And I speak for the entire ecosystem, whether it is the vehicle manufacturers, whether it is the component manufacturers, and the entire ecosystem, the way the government has supported us, it's been fantastic and phenomenal. It's real sheer camaraderie that has seen us through. And honestly, I haven't heard a single ACMA member go bust. Okay, so this is something very, very important from a business dynamics perspective. We have seen many downturns, but probably this was one of the most challenging ones, and every downturn has made us strong, and so has this one. But I just hope that everybody remains safe and we do not have any such grave challenge that's life-threatening, of course, I wish that a sustainable growth comes back to the industry, and that, you know, the government has a long-term roadmap for the industry for us to jointly walk on for the good of the whole nation.
Thank you so much, sir. We also wish a sustainable growth for each and every industry.
Thank you. Awesome. Thank you. Your challenge, a lot of luck. Good luck. You guys are doing a good job. So continue to do so.
Thank you so much. It means a lot for us. With that, we'll wrap up today's interactive session with Mr. Vinnie Mehta, Director General of ACMA. Thank you, Mr. Mehta, for being on the show and sharing a kind of a detailed insight on the automotive component industry. Viewers, stay tuned for more such interactive sessions. And don't forget to subscribe our YouTube channel and press the bell icon. Thank you so much and goodbye.